everybody. So one of the things that the Lord has been showing me lately is that when, you know, we post information on the internet, we make videos on YouTube or BitChute or whatever your platform happens to be, Facebook, it's very easy to get into debates with people about your particular views, your opinions, if that's true or false. And so sometimes it's really hard to sift through what is true and what is error. The main thing, our plumb line as Christians, should always be the Word of God. The Word of God is sufficient for all teaching and doctrine. And we're also in the Bible, it says in 2 Timothy 2:5, to rightly divide the Word of truth, which means to study the Word and be students of Scripture. Be like Bereans, go to the Scripture and find out whether these things are so. And when it comes to comments and people that disagree with you, it's very important to be gracious and loving with these people, because it comes down to the fact that people have lots of philosophies and ideas. According to Colossians, it talks about many traditions of men, a lot of philosophies that don't line up with the Word of God. And so a lot of these people are biblically illiterate. They don't even know what the Bible says. And when they do quote Scripture, they do not quote it with good hermeneutics, which is an interpretation of Scripture. So they don't quote it within the context of what that verse means. You have to read the verses before and you have to read the verses after to understand the context. And then you can also cross-reference. So Scripture interprets Scripture. Look at other Scriptures. Compare the context with other things. And then you will get a better meaning of the Scripture. A guy that I love to go to is John MacArthur. He's a great Bible expositor. And so when you're talking about verses such as no one knows the day or the hour, when we talk about the rapture being an imminent event and somebody says, well, you don't know the day of the rapture, or you don't know the season of the rapture because the Bible says no one knows the day or the hour. Well, let me give an example. In Matthew 24, you have the parable of the fig tree. The parable of the fig tree is talking about Israel and how, you know, summer is near. And then right after that parable is concluded, then you see the next verse. It says, no one knows the day or the hour. Therefore, watch, for the Son of Man comes in an hour you think not. So he's talking about watching, that we will know the season. We will know the time that the Lord is going to return, that we won't be surprised because we're sons of light and not sons of the dark. So again, going back to the comments, when people spout off like, oh, that the rapture theory is false, you're teaching false doctrine, a lot of times they can never back that up with solely Scripture, because they only have these philosophies, these traditions that are nullifying the Word of God, as Mark chapter 7 says. It's nullifying the Word of God. And so they don't know the Word of God. They're biblically illiterate. They're not students of Scripture. So they're just pulling these ideas from the world. And what does the Bible say about that? We're supposed to cast down arguments and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of Christ and bring it captive in obedience to Christ. Because many philosophies, many false teachings, a lot of philosophies have gone out into the world that are not according to Scripture. We're supposed to be students of Scripture, rightly dividing the Word of truth. All Scripture is sufficient, and God has given us all things that pertain to life and godliness. So I just implore all of you, if you're in a debate on a chat room or in comment sections, always be gracious, always be loving, operate in the Spirit of God and not in the flesh. Don't become angry. It even says in Timothy, it says to avoid foolish disputes and bring everything captive to the Word of God. And share the Word of God, because God's Word does not return void, but accomplishes the purpose for which it is sent. And so I just encourage everybody out there in these last days, as we're looking, we're running to and fro from Scripture to Scripture, trying to interpret the signs of the times, which is good. It's not, we're not supposed to not do that. Christ says, watch, be ready. Otherwise, this day will overtake you as a thief. Right? So there's lots of Scriptures that say, watch and be ready and look and, you know, have a little fun with it. God is a practical God. He's a relational God. He wants us to have a relationship with us. He desires to give good gifts to his children. He wants to conceal these secrets to his servants, the ones that are looking intently. Even Jesus says, come, let us reason together, right? From the Scriptures. So again, I encourage all of you to look into the Scriptures, and may God bless your day.